Today, I'm going to show you how good Becca can be. But before we do that, we need to clarify something. If I hit a zombie in the body and it's a red damage, that means critical hit. So now what if I told you that when I walk out here, every single shot I take, I guarantee you is going to be red, and I'm not going to shoot them in the head. Every single shot I take is going to be red. Doesn't matter where, doesn't matter how. I could shoot him in the arm, I could shoot him in the leg. Here, I'll do the arm, I'll do the gut, I'll do the chest. You know, close enough, I'll do the leg again. Every single shot you're gonna take is going to be a critical hit with this build. And then, to top it off, what if I told you that with the MUP, the crappiest starting pistol in the game, I could do over 1,000 damage. Today, we're gonna show you, finally, Sniper Becca. Hello everyone, my name is SwingPoynt and welcome to Resident Evil Resistance. Today, I'm going to show you, finally, Sniper Becca, and I'm so excited that we can release this, that I finally got it put together. Sniper Becca destroys zombies. What's really interesting about Becca, I'm going to give you guys a lot of numbers today, and you guys are going to be like, whoa, when you think about them. But one thing to start things off that's very interesting is that Becca has the lowest win rate. It used to be Sam by a long shot, but like I had said before, once people started figuring out Sam, it was going to skyrocket, and sure enough, he's up to par with pretty much everyone else now. Becca is the lowest one by a few percentage points. And part of me thinks it's because people don't know how to use Becca. They don't know her potential. They go, oh, Becca, that girl with the ult and the constant shooting, give her a rocket launcher, that's all she's good for. No, Becca can be really good if you use her right. So we're gonna go over how to make Becca really good, okay? So let's go over the skills and equipment of Sniper Becca. The point of Sniper Becca is 100% critical hit rate. It is not max damage inside her equipment. It is always be critting, which is going to be even better than using your equipment for max damage, okay? So let's start from the bottom and go up. So for her first passive, we're going to look at cause headshot at enemies to drop a moderate amount of ammo. I choose that one because I want more ammo and because you may as well be headshotting if you're playing Sniper Becca, because it's about precision. One thing that's really nice about Sniper Becca is because she hits so hard, she really doesn't need that much ammo. When you think of Becca, you think, oh, I'm going to buy ammo. I'm going to buy ammo. I'm going to buy ammo because that's what she does. No, you don't need to buy a lot of ammo on Becca because she's so strong. Now, on to her second one. This is a really big deal. You need to have this. It's actually her default skill. And one thing I think is really cool about, you know, letting this marinate for a couple of weeks is when Becca came out, I was like, oh, I think I'd like Mind's Eye a little bit better. Nope, I was wrong. So, focus aim is what you're really going to want for this build because it greatly increases your chance of critical hits while your reticle is fully focused. Then you might be like, SwingPoynt, well, I can't shoot as fast if my reticle has to be fully focused. But we're gonna talk about how to make it go fast to the point where you're gonna be doing way more damage than you could with your quick draw, firing all six bullets out, and then reloading. And now for the personal skill, Sentry Stance. When I first started playing Becca, I thought this was kind of bad because it caused you to sit in place, and you're like, well, I lose my mobility. You'd still lose your mobility. I don't have any tricks for that, but you're going to do so much damage that it's not going to matter. So what we're going to do here is we're going to have Swift on. When you go into Swift, you get a 30% damage boost for 10 seconds when you are in your sentry stance. Now you can use Escalation, and that will gradually increase your damage all the way up to 2x damage, but it's a tick per second. It goes up to 20 ticks, and it takes 6 seconds to reach the same benefit that Swift has. So it's just not practical. That's too immobile for what we're trying to do here. With Sentry Stance on Swift, you can go up, down, whoop, up, down, whoop, up, down. So you can keep doing that, keep dishing out constant increased damage. Now to her Fever skill. I do rapid cooldown, base cooldown 150 seconds. Our critical hit rate's already through the roof as it is. Taking that 90 seconds off is totally worth it in my opinion. So now let's take a look at her equipment. We're not running full damage here. What we're running is increased critical hit rate, and then we're running some damage here. And the damage that we're running is hollow point 3 and hollow point 2, and I don't think these were in the game until the Jill update. Sorry if I'm wrong there, but these allow us to do really cool things with Sniper Becca. So with these two long barrels, comboed up with the fact that she has focus aim on in one of her passives, her critical hit rate, while her reticle is focused, is like 99.99999%. Every once in like a week, you're gonna have one bullet the entire night you're playing that isn't a critical hit. She basically has a 100% critical hit rate. And now I'm going to go into the math as to why that matters over just full damage, okay? So before we get into that math, though, I'll talk about hollow point rounds. I did the testing on it. Hollow point rounds increase the damage of your critical hits. So considering we're 100% critical hit rate, that means our damage is always boosted. It's not just when we hit a crit, it's all the time, which is really cool. So greatly increased critical hit damage, hollow point 3, is a 20.2% boost in critical hit damage. Moderate, or hollow point 2, is a 12% boost, and then slightly, or hollow point 1, is an 8.1% boost. But now you configure this as a straight damage boost rather than just those once in a while critical hits, because literally every hit you do is going to be a critical hit, which is awesome. And to go back, something I should have mentioned before with Sentry Stance, how are you going to deal with that reticle that takes forever to close in? Sentry Stance makes your reticle close in way faster. Even with the quick draw, this is very feasible with the quick draw. In fact, I would recommend you use it. The quick draw for my testing is the most damage per bullet that you're going to get, even over the Lightning Hawk. I tested the Lightning Hawk on Biocore. I got 2093 for my crit damage, and then I used the quick draw and I got 811. And now the Lightning Hawk uses 4 bullets per shot, quick draw uses 1. And the Lightning Hawk's slow, the quick draw is fast, and you can do a better ult with the quick draw. You're gonna do more damage over time, no matter what way you split it, with the quick draw. The one thing that the Lightning Hawk does really well is that it can one-shot a Tuffy. It can probably one-shot a Licker if you're framed up right. That's the cool part about the Lightning Hawk. It's that burst damage on heads. And now I'm not sure, but I feel like she can one-hit Yorick.
Very yep. Well. Take its key if you want.
Now there's some things I want to show you in the lab, and I definitely want to show you what she's like in a real match so you can kind of understand how Sentry Stance is going to work and how it's very feasible. But let's go over some really interesting numbers so you can understand why you don't want to go full damage here. You want to make sure your critical hit chance is 100%. So I'm about to give you a lot of information here based off of the numbers I have from the MUP. So keep in mind, that is the weakest gun in the game. It only gets way better from there. But we're going to understand why we do what we do with the focus shot. That's what I like to instill in you guys. There's a reason why we do things. So if you take the MUP and you fire that gun not focused in, you're going to do 180 damage to the gut. We're focusing on gut shots because it's a nice way to go ahead and keep things consistent, big target. You do 180 damage on the gut, unfocused. You do 270 damage when it's focused in, your reticle's tight. That means a 50% damage boost. Now, on top of that, you get another 50% damage boost on top of the 270 if you're hitting a critical hit, okay? That brings that number to 405. And then we go ahead and we add hollow point 3 and hollow point 2. When they're added up together, they are doing another 32% more damage. So that's going to bring your damage up to 534. And then to top it off, we're going to put her into sentry stance, which is going to be another 30% damage boost. Okay? So when you do all of that math, we are now at 695 damage per shot to the gut. So we did all of that math and we made it so that we're doing 695 damage per shot. To put that in perspective from the 180, that means that you are doing 386% more damage with every single shot you take if you frame her up this way. And to talk about what I did in the intro, let's understand how much damage does to each body part. Now, in order of damage, head does the most damage, gut does the second most, chest does the third most, and then limbs do the fourth most. There's no difference between arms and hands or feet and legs. So, a gut shot is what I kept going for, but now if you turn that into a headshot, you get another 50% damage increase. So, that's how you're hitting 1,043 damage every time you shoot the gun, no matter what, because it's a 100% critical hit chance when you put Becca into sentry stance and shoot at the head. And now this is with the MUP. This is the crappiest gun in the game. It only goes higher, guys. And now there's some things I want to show you in the lab right now regarding body parts and then also lickers, which makes this really interesting. Because something you might think, well, Becca, she's stationary. If a licker charges at her, what is she going to do? Let me show you. So now I'm in the lab here and I have the quick draw. And when you have the quick draw, you're like, oh god, it takes so long to focus. There's no way I could do this fully focused reticle build. Well, that's where Sentry Stance comes to the rescue. So I go whoop, and then it closes in real fast. And then you take a shot and it goes back like that. You see that? So you can just keep firing those. Bam, 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 bam. And you are going to be able to just wipe out so many all at the same time. And now I'm using the quick draw, and you can see I got, what, 1,400 damage on the head? 1,460? You can use the Matilda if you want those 24 bullets. You're going to do a little bit less damage, but your reticle is going to focus faster, so it's really up to you how you want to play. A basic zombie has 875 health.
I've got this.
All the other specialty ones except for the toughie have closer to 1,000. Look at that. Crazy. All the other specialty ones have closer to about 1,000-ish, and then the toughies have about 2,400, and then the liquors, they have around 3,500, I think. But again, take a look at this. 1, 2, 3, and pop. And now, just imagine you go into the first area here, you set up back here, and then you got like three zombies, you go boop, 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 boop. Take them all out. Clear it out for your whole team. Just Becca on her own. Never mind the fact that the other three are going to be doing damage. Now, there is something I want to show you that I'm going to use the MUP for. Now, you see Tuffy over here? You can disable limbs in this game. So, I'm going to take out, let's say...
Taking aim.
This leg. Boom. And then boom. And then boom. See how his leg went down? Now, what you'll notice is you can take out limbs. You can do this to arms, and you can do this to legs. And you can tell it's broken because it turns black. That will not happen unless the limb's broken. So he's only ever going to crawl around now. You can do that with their arms, too. So if you ever want to take one out, you know, typically what happens is you just shoot him in the head. And you end up taking them out before they even get a chance to have that happen. But that's something I noticed during my testing, and I figured you guys would want to know. But again, like in practice, you know what's going to happen before you can disable a limb? You're just going to go be like, nope. And then they're never even going to stand a chance. And also, keep in mind, if you ever need to, you can still do this. You can still pour into him. It's still something you can do, so don't feel like you can't do that. Alright, so I got a liquor chasing me. And something that Becca can do to liquors is she can stunlock them. Boom, 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 boom. If that doesn't make you interested in Sniper Becca, I don't know what's gonna. You can stunlock anything in place because you're critting it every single time. And I don't know, maybe critical hits cause a knockback, but no matter what you shoot, that's going to happen to it. Including liquors, which is pretty cool, right? Oh god, he's going to scream. So we're in a match now. We'll see how it goes. We got a Tyrone, a Sam, and a Martin, and then Sniper Becca. Sniper Becca, comboed up with Sam, is going to be a really strong offensive comp, and then, you know, Tyrone over the top is going to be really good for keeping us up. If he has Dr. Tyrone going on, which is going to be a video we're going to do, that'd be really interesting. One thing that's going to be really nice synergy, oh, assuming that Sam doesn't leave here. One really nice synergy is that Martin is going to be able to flash zombies and stun them in place. So that makes really easy targets for Becca. I should say, you do need to be able to aim with this build. Oh, it's a level 2. I always get the babies when we go ahead and do these videos. One thing that Becca's really good for, Sniper Becca, is that she does that really high damage, bonjour, right? So when he's controlling zombies, you get that like nuking damage, I guess we could call it, where you just and obliterate whatever's coming at you. I do like running Matilda because it allows me to take out camps pretty easy. Watch your feet, everyone. Yeah, we got a baby Martin here. Not a baby Martin, baby Daniel. I gotta move! One thing that sucks is he takes reduced damage when he's doing that, but everyone together should be able to take him out pretty easy. Look at that. Boom. If that was something you needed, that was pretty much all Sniper Becca there. We didn't get any help from anyone, which is pretty cool. And now again, you can keep moving. Like, you don't have to go into sentry stance, and you'll figure out when to. You'll figure out if it makes sense. You'll learn a little bit more about your scenarios, and you'll understand your team that you have. You don't always have to be going into sentry stance here. But now this can be really good at taking him out like that. Look at that. Look at that. Like, it's really good, man. People think Becca's just her ult, and she's so much more than that. And I was the same. I was like, ew. Sentry stance. Ew. And it does decrease your mobility, and there's going to be times where you... Uh-oh. There's going to be times where you try to do something, it doesn't work out for you. but you can just really wreck with her, and she's so good at conserving resources, which is clutch. Oh. Kill that off there. Like, I need to fire a bullet, and it's dead. You know what I mean? On top of the fact that if you're hitting headshots, you go pick up a bunch of ammo. Sometimes I only get one bullet, which is not how that's supposed to operate, but sometimes you'll get like 12, and that could be 12 freaking zombies that go down with the way Becca plays. I should get back with my team here because I'm too busy talking and not helping them. Gotta drop my mup too. Stay. Boing, boing. See, like, I don't have to go into sentry stance for that. I was just trying to have fun and get a good shot in. But you are going to only hit crits if you focus your shot in, which is just disgusting. I told you what, it was like 386% more damage or something like that.
Ready to get shooting.
Oh, they got it. I see you got on the objective. I'm sitting here being a doofus, just trying to get my shots in. So even though I already have the Matilda, I still want the quick draw because of the way Becca plays. I could go Lightning Hawk here. Actually, no, I couldn't. I don't have enough cash on me. We didn't actually get a whole bunch that last time. And I'm still going to buy ammo here. Actually, no, I'm not going to. I'm gonna make sure, nice ult, I guess. I'm gonna make sure I have my green herb so I can keep myself healing. I have to manually heal myself with the way this build is. So that's something to keep in mind. Where is he? Oh, he's already dead. Well, I did like 600 damage to a freaking controlled zombie there. It's a pretty big deal. One thing that does get in your way sometimes when you play Sniper Becca is your teammates. You can't see what's happening because they stand in front of you. But usually you can just kind of shoot into the pile and you're still going to be doing a ton of damage and knocking creatures back, which is plenty helpful for your team. All right, where are we going here? Oh, Yorick's already dead. He was beating on him. Dang, I love shooting Yorick with Sniper Becca because it's like two or three shots and he's down, which is just beautiful. But again, this is a baby Daniel, so don't expect anything too crazy out of this match. I think what we are seeing a good example of, though, is being able to go ahead and... Oh, can I kill him? Oh yeah, 975. No, it's 875. Sometimes they have like a last stand, which is kind of goofy. But look, you knock everything down. You stunlock whatever you shoot, which is amazing.
The perfect machine for this endeavor.
Boing. Alrighty, let's keep going here.
Taking aim.
Just spawning crawlers everywhere. I think he has. Could he have? Because zombies typically have 875 health, but they're not dying, so I wonder if he has boosted health on. Can you even do that with Daniel? When he's ranked 2? I don't think you can, so I don't know what's going on. Usually they have 875. Oh, I got yellow herbs on me. Nice. So you throw yellow herbs on her, she's even more disgusting. Oh, we got a Tuffy here. Oh, I can't see. No, the dog! What's really nice, we got two boys on our team that are going to go ahead and melee everything for us. So where's the last area here, huh? Where it is. Oh, he's working on it up there. I think I hear Mr. X up there, too. Let me go ahead and put you onto here, and then you onto here. And then I'll use my yellow orb when I feel like it. Pretty sure they're just running away right now, though, so. Oh, hey, they got the objective done. Cool. It'll make for a nice quick match. Make it for a short video here, and you guys can still kind of understand everything I'm trying to show you, which is great. So let's just run around here. One thing I'd love to test is for somebody to get grabbed and then see if sentry stance with the quick draw is going to be enough to knock Mr. X out of his pulverize.
Thank you, Daniel. It was most
I would not be surprised. But let's just get out of here. Frankly, I'm being more of a nuisance to my team because I'm just talking so much. We got 10 minutes here, so we should be good. And we're cruising through it so fast that I don't think we're going to be able to... Yeah, I can't even buy the lightning rod. So I'm just going to try to rush out there. Run, 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 run. And I still have my bio cores on me, so... Uh-oh. Gun?
I've got this.
Still take that out in one hit, which is nice.
Sometimes it's easiest just to do things yourself. You understand me.
He's gunning for me. He knows. He knows I'm trouble. Oop. There we go. Didn't focus in time. Let's go ahead and pull this. Oh, I hope we get spark shot. You get a lot of spark shots in this thing, but spark shots against no knockback Daniel or just controlled creatures in general is really nice. Oh, rockets? Meh. I'll take it, but meh. Yeah. So let's show you how good this is against cores. Honestly, I don't know if I'll be able to, though, if Sam's going to be there in time. Yeah, Sam's going to be there in wreck before I... Oh, I should be up top helping. It's the first time I've seen him use a gun all game, I'm pretty sure, so I wasn't expecting that. Okay, well, let's just keep rolling here. And now she can do pretty wicked damage to cores with this thing. Now, I do have my ult, which I could use, but I want to show you what it's like when she doesn't have her ult up. So, let me just try to get that in. Hopefully he doesn't start hounding on me again. He's probably going to, but... Let's take a peek. So, what's really nice about this, you go into sentry stance, you can still do a lot of damage really quickly. Like, you see that? Now, I gotta reload. This is the bad part about the quick draw, so if I wanted to, I could just do a lot of these. And still do a lot of damage. But I like using the quick draw because it's fun.
I confess, I admire.
And now you saw my damage drop off there?
Breaking shit, but this is hopeless.
That's because the sentry stance, after 10 seconds, I think, goes ahead and stops boosting your damage. So you gotta pop up out of it every once in a while if you wanna, you know, get max damage out of it. Look at that. Isn't that disgusting? Just pop, pop, down. Rocket launcher for Becca? Perhaps? I don't see one.
You ready for this?
You ready for this, man? I'm ready for it. And now, it wouldn't be a Becca if we didn't go ahead and use our ult, but, you know, frankly, you're seeing we don't even need to use the ult. It's, she's so strong. We're also going against a Daniel who, you know, is brand new, so. And now you can still clear things out like that. Oh, boy. Okay. 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 I felt a little cornered.
You have no hope.
Becca does have less health. Probably due to this damage that she can do. Y'all really doing this? You're gonna get destroyed. Oh my lord. Wow, he recovered out of that quick. Yeah, terrible idea, guys. You're getting greedy. Just run away from the crazy, scary tall man. Don't let him team wipe us.
The cogs turn.
Well,
the bows of the
that first aid spray on me?
Place.
Nope.
You are
hello.
Close to the point of no return.
Oh, he's ready for the rampart, huh? Okay, I gotta run. Nope. He's about to bull rush. Yep. They're all gonna die.
Okay.
And I probably won't be able to pick him up because I'm gonna get shot right here, right? He's totally gonna shoot me. Yeah. I figured.
That's a whole lot better.
Well, Becca to save the day here, huh? No! Okay, that's the one time you don't want to use sentry stance. I got greedy. So I'm going to do now is I actually am going to sit back a little bit. Oh my god, I'm going to be poisoned too. He's got that clear. Now, this is where this gets kind of important because I need to start clearing this out so we don't get overwhelmed.
This is not a very efficient way of ending your life.
There we go. Okay, you know what? You want some too, mister? So you do have that to your disposal if you need it.
Fuck you all.
Now, what I will say is, when you play for yourself, I would, you know, make sure you pay attention to what's going on around you. I am trying to show off Sniper Becca sentry stance a lot in this video, probably more than I need to. It's because it's so fun. Like, when I went and I sat down right in front of the door with the zombies right in front of me and it was a armored zombie, not a smart idea. But, you know, I just want to do it. So I'm actually going to go ahead and pull up this bad boy because I kind of forgot I had it. I'm not sure if sentry stance affects these things. Now that I think about it. Y'all pull the door? Let's see. Woo! Kind of seems like it does, doesn't it? Well, there you go. Sniper Becca. I know it was a weaker mastermind. I always seem to run into that whenever I go to record these things, but if you want to see higher level gameplay and us doing stuff against higher level players, you can always go to twitch.tv/swingpoint because we stream there every single night, 10 p.m. Eastern.
Enjoy the air and run.
And that's where we do a lot of our build theory crafting. That's how we come up with things like Sniper Becca. That's how we go ahead and test out some really good stuff against some really good teams and some really good masterminds. But I think I covered everything I wanted to talk about in here. I hope you guys have a whole new insight onto how Becca works. She can be really good, especially with a team that knows that she can be really good. We already know what she could do with her alts. That's, it's very face value. It's like, oh, of course, she has a really strong alt. But it's when you go ahead and you combo some things up with her equipment and her skills where you go, wow, she's good the whole match, not just, you know, every 150 seconds. So I hope you learned a thing or two. Like I said, we stream every night, 10 p.m. Eastern. We also start a little bit earlier on YouTube with those streams. You can always check me out, twitch.tv/swingpoint. I'd love to have you over there. I have more videos planned. I want to get Immortal Sam out. I want to get Dr. Tyrone and maybe some other stuff with all of the mixtape stuff that's going about. We'll see. But thank you so much for being here. You guys are awesome. I hope you enjoyed Sniper Becca. And then I will see you guys in the next video that we do around here.